We have Wink News reporter Paul Dolan live at the Boathouse. And Paul, I just want to know what's the latest updates that you're learning from the Boathouse?
Yeah, Lauren, take a good look at the damage to this once popular bar and restaurant. Now as burnt shell is all that's left of the Boathouse, Tiki Bar and Grille. And authorities aren't sure how it started. A charred and splintered frame is what's left of the Cape Coral Boathouse, Tiki Bar and Grille. Robert D'Alessandro and Denise Zolpa headed over for lunch Friday and didn't expect this.
Just came back down. This is the first place we're going to come to.
Part of the Boathouse turned to ash, a wooden frame standing on what looks like balance beam planks. The very sight is enough to make Robert sick.
Sick.
Yeah. Sad.
I feel for the owners. It's not right, but. And yes. Our kids would come down, we'd bring them here. They loved it.
The winds, Cape Fire believes, helped spread the flames, with the fire lighting up the night sky.
Last night, it was equally as windy, so that really helped move the fire to other parts of the restaurant. There was also a very heavy fuel load with the thatched roof of the Tiki Bar.
It took 4 hours to fight the fire at the restaurant that had just reopened Thursday following Hurricane Milton. Andrea Shook with the Cape Coral Fire Department told me the building's materials likely contributed to the fire spreading so rapidly.
The damage is pretty much building-wide, so the roof, as you can see, because of the type of material that it was, it did burn away. There is parts of the structure that are still standing. Whether or not they are able to be accessed is unlikely. It would be structurally unsound.
The investigation has been completed and the building turned back over to the owner. Now, it's unclear what the actual cause of the fire was, but authorities are not ruling out electrical. And it's unclear whether or not the owners plan on rebuilding. Reporting live in Cape Coral, Paul Dolan, Wink News.
All right, thank you, Paul.